Hey, Facebook and YouTube, Gordon Ong with Tyler Larson. Video team, he's going to help me unbox what we just reboxed, the Omen X, HP's brand new Omen X. Of course, you saw the actual case itself a couple weeks ago. HP actually sent us a full build, and I'm actually very interested to see what's inside of it, and I'm going to talk about what's so exciting about the Omen X and the voodoo DNA that is in the machine. It's too heavy, though, so Tyler's going to help me get it out of the box. We had pulled off the top earlier and then started to take it out when our feed died, so we're doing it all over again. I have not taken this off. It's not technically been really unboxed. And it is heavy if you buy a full system, so don't think you can sneak this into your house and not have your wife or husband notice. Someone will notice this thing in your house. Okay, we got it out. Todd's gonna make that disappear. I'm gonna take off this cool. So, again, this is HP's brand new Omen X. If you don't know, it's a crazy looking case. There really is nothing out there because HP had this built specifically to their own design. It harkens back to Voodoo. If anybody remember Voodoo PC of the late 90s, early 2000s? They made awesome computers. They got bought by HP. The world blew up in 2007. Voodoo sort of vanished between the waves of the sea. 2017, HP has brought Voodoo DNA back in the HP Omen X with a custom design case that we're gonna get into if I can. Oh, great, the screw's missing. So you threw this and you push the eject button. I like all the little, all along this case, you get these little kind of hints. It says eject here. It says remove to access power supply. Hey, there's a fan under here. It tells you that. Kind of nice little touches. Even along the bottom of the case, it has little things like this. Omen internal access. A lot of really, really nice touches. But let's see what's inside here. Because what I will say about Voodoo PCs is they really set the standard for detailed, beautiful interiors. Really sort of, before Voodoo really did its magic, a lot of even high-end PCs weren't quite as beautiful as Voodoo PCs in the inside. So let's see what we get in here. Pretty nice. Oh, so this again is HP's Omen X. We're unboxing it, we're doing it live. If you have any questions about the Omen X, please ask away. So inside, this is, I haven't gotten the price of this build, but I'm gonna guess it must be over $3,000 because I'm seeing two video cards. I don't even know what the video cards are, but clearly they're NVIDIA because we have a high bandwidth bridge. I'm guessing dual 1080s, maybe dual 1070s. Probably dual 1070s because we've got single 8 pins. So dual 1070 box. Looks like an M.2 SSD, probably NVMe, I'm gonna hope. Pretty plain looking RAM, I gotta say. But one of the pitches HP is making with the Omen X is if you buy a gaming rig from a large mainstream company that is competitor to them. They don't want to say who it is, but clearly it's Alienware. It's not going to be as clean inside. They're going to say there's a lot of metal that's not painted. On the Omen X, they're saying, hey, we painted everything black. We did a custom case, and it's going to look beautiful on the inside. I got to say, for the most part, it is actually very clean in here. I mean, the RAM is a little plain. I got to say, you know, it could be nicer. These cables would be nicer if it were braided, but, you know, not bad.
Hassan asked, what's the CPU?
Oh, so the CPU in here, I believe, is a 6700K, so quad 6700K Skylake part. Yeah, it would be nice to have Kaby Lake, but, you know, I think they have a Kaby Lake in a lower-end configuration, but, you know, for the most part, it's not going to make a huge difference to somebody. I'm sure they're going to be upgrading this. So very clean on the inside. Of course, if you want to know, you're going, like, where's the power supply? The power supply, of course, is in here. Let me see if I can get, where's my special tool? Oh, great, I lost it. What the hell did I do with the, well.
There's another one on the table.
Oh, can I have another? Thank you. So we're gonna just, so the power supply, so this is in here. The whole design is to keep all your parts separated. You've got the GPUs in the main compartment, the CPU in the main compartment, it's all sealed off. So none of the heat from the hard drives, like you're really gonna be running a lot, and the power supply can heat up the components. I'm gonna use the universal tool that you get with every computer to get in here. These are great. I will show you four things you can do with this. So it's just a standard power supply, right? A little pigtail to get it in there. Very nice. And then actually here's some other cool touches. You get your hard drives and SSDs. How do I get this open? Here we go. Slide to unlock. So quick release, hard drive bays, four of them. Two of them I believe are sized for 3.5 inch drives and two of them are sized for 2.5 inch drives. So you can put your SSD in. Let's see if they put anything in here. Nope.
Two questions, is there a heat sink and how much is this thing?
So I don't actually have the price of this. But I think, let me look at, I do have the prices of some of the configs. First, if you don't know, you can actually buy this case if you want to buy it, which is totally unusual for a large company. $550 for just the case itself. Certainly not cheap, but you're buying a high-end case, you're getting something unique. A 6700K with a single GTX 1080 and 32 gigs of RAM is about $2,600. I think this may be a dual 1070 system. So I'm guessing maybe $2,500. It actually may not be that expensive. You can actually, HP actually has a pretty reasonable build here. They've got one that's a quad locked Kaby Lake part, but you're getting a 1070, 128 gig SSD hard drive, 8 gigs of RAM for $1,600. You know, that's actually not bad getting, you know, a 1070 box with a quad core Kaby Lake, especially with this pretty nice case in here. So I don't have the price. I'm gonna guess $3,000. So again, for people tuning in, we just unboxed HP's brand new Omen X, a full build. Last week we did the case. If you have any questions you want to know about this, this of course has the, you know, famous Voodoo DNA, if you're old enough to remember Voodoo computing.
What was that other question you had?
The other question, yes, the other question was, does it have a heat sink? Yes, it does. It is a CLC, closed loop cooler. The motherboard is, and one thing you should know about this case is it is a micro ATX design. So full ATX would add maybe another 3 inches, 4 inches to the case. It would make this thing even bigger than it is. And they're probably a good decision to just go with a standard micro ATX. Most people are not running more than two video cards. Of course, you can get an Alienware with up to three video cards in it. In the old days, I don't know what they're gonna do with that design these days. One other thing I'm going to point out is you are getting on this case USB Type-C ports. You get two of them. They're wired into the case. Pretty nice, but looking at the case internally, it uses, looks like it's USB 3.1, USB 3 10 gig. So it's sorry, let's say that again. This is USB 5 gig, not 10 gig. Man, it is Friday, isn't it? So those ports on the front, on the top, are USB-C, but they're not 10 gig. They're probably older USB 3.0, 5 gig, and that, of course, is because the new connectors, all the motherboards that support the new USB 3.1 10 gig front panel connectors just recently came out. Probably not enough time to get it into this design.
What about the special tool?
Let's show the... you get your little secret toolkit. This is a very nice touch. It's actually connected on magnets, but I don't have any fingernails right now. You have to be careful because it does have a power cable. The case does light up. We should actually plug this thing and light it up and see how it lights up. So the logo in front lights up, and you get sort of an emergency toolkit here. Spare screws, because we all lose the screws. They drop on the floor and go away. An emergency screwdriver. which is kind of handy for emergencies. You're not going to want to build with that. And then this, I believe, is a tool to unlock or lock the hard drive cages.
Nice. Why don't you go power it up?
Yeah, let's plug this baby in, see what it looks like.
Any other questions, Dan?
Yeah, if anybody has any questions, now would be a good time to ask. Okay, again, this is the HP Omen X. We just unboxed it. I'm going to power it on to see how pretty it looks when it's lit up. I guess we should put the door on. Pretty neat door. Question is, where's the power switch? Ah, right here. Ready?
Yep, let's do it. Ooh. Those are nice case lights.
I like the case lights. It's actually pretty cool. If you buy the case itself, you actually get the hookups for the LEDs, and it will plug into a USB header on your Microtex motherboard. You can actually change the colors and do all kinds of nifty stuff, even if you buy just the case itself. A lot of the designs can be proprietary. You got to have their special motherboard and stuff, but that those days seem to be kind of beyond us.
What about the inside? Does it light up on the inside at all? Or?
You know, I don't think this one actually does, which...
Ricardo asks if you need to put the case on the stand.
So you do actually, this is not even a stand. These are actually legs. This case is designed to stand up like this. HP says, hey, we're doing this because you suck air in these vents here. And it comes in here, goes out. So again, this is the power supply, hard drives, CPU and GPU all in here. So they really want you to run it like this.
So you couldn't actually detach those legs and lay it flat on its side?
I don't think you should. You probably, I guess you could if you wanted to break them off, but, and actually this is pretty tricky. I didn't mention this before, but you're like, hey, I want my optical drive. You actually get an optical drive, which is, So again, if you laid it down flat, it's not gonna happen. Also, the orientation of all the logos would not really work. It's really designed to stand up like this. Of course, people go, is that really practical? It's like, yeah, it's practical because you want the thing to get in people's faces. You want to look different. That's one way of looking different. It's not just a box sitting on the floor, which we've had for many years. And look, you've got your cool optical drive here. Pretty cool, huh?
Cool. All right, what are you gonna be doing with this, Gordon?
Okay, so we're gonna be doing a full review on this. We actually have a full stable of just awesome machines. A couple other ones I'll talk about later. And we also have an empty case that I'm going to be building a machine out of. I'm really hoping to do a Ryzen build in an Omen X. So stay tuned. I've got to get a Ryzen and a Micro ATX motherboard, and who knows when that's going to happen. But stay tuned, PC World. More unboxings, because you'll like to see it come out of the box.